everyone. Thank you for coming and listening to some of the music that we have to offer. What are you looking for is the theme we're discussing. And I am so glad that Siddharth had talked about mirrors, because our music is largely about mirrors. And we managed to find, Maria and I managed to find three pieces that have mirror in a title, which is pretty remarkable for classical music to find it. And the way this program will be structured is we want to sort of present it as a day of meditation and self-inquiry, because Krishnamurti's teachings are really all about self-inquiry. If there's one thing that I would say that I know about Krishnamurti, is that it's the self-examination that makes you the better person, or makes you grow. So how is this arc of the day going to look like? We will begin with a slow meditative piece by Arvo Part called Spiegel im Spiegel, Mirror in the Mirror. So again, the piece is really talking about infinity of mirrors, of reflection of self and the world around you. I will introduce the pieces a little bit as we go, but the arc of the day, I want you to listen with it like this. When you wake up, you're going to be quiet. As you go through the day, things will happen. You'll have interactions with people. You have interactions with nature and the town you live in. And then the day ends and you fall asleep. So my sister Maria will join me for the first piece. And this is Arvo Part, Spiegel im Spiegel. I do want to say one more thing, which is there was a daily quote by Krishnamurti that was sent out yesterday, and it's so perfect. Words are necessary to communicate, but words are necessary to communicate, but for most of us, the word is the mind, and we are slaves to words. So why this means so much to me is music can express so much more than words can ever do. So I want you to think about it, because there's so much I can say and also so little I can say. And really what's left is your experience of this music. Thank you. Thank you. next two pieces are by Maurice Ravel. The title of the cycle is Mirrors. And I selected two pieces. Coincidentally, Ravel wrote these when he was living in a commune. And it sort of reminds me of this, because it's a gathering of minds and artists and thinkers. But the specific, I think, mirror that Ravel is talking about here in these pieces is nature. The first piece you'll hear is about birds. Second, about bells, church bells specifically. And it's so uncanny that we're sitting here in Ojai and I heard birds singing the whole time when Arvo Part piece was being played by us. They're present with us all the time. Church bells go off in Ojai downtown as well. So hopefully this is fitting for you all. I have to remind myself of a quote by Krishnamurti, which is, if you lose touch with nature, you lose touch with yourself. I promised myself I would remember this, but in the heat of the moment, you forget. But that's so true that we see ourselves in nature, and it's the biggest mirror. So please enjoy the next two pieces. So the next piece is with violin. It's a movement from Frank Sonata. César Franck was a Belgian composer. This to us represents the daily interaction, the dialogue between people, every being. You'll see that this piece has a lot of melodies that are being passed around from violin to piano and vice versa. Sometimes it's a call and a response. Sometimes it's a continuation of the melody. We kind of switch off who starts and who responds. And I think it really greatly represents how we communicate and how we mirror things in each other as we go through the day. I also wanted to add that we will, this will be the second to last piece. And I would like to basically move on to the last piece immediately because I want you guys to think about ending, how a day ends, essentially just sitting with yourself, falling back asleep. The title of the next piece, the last piece, is Still by Ola Guerrero. And I mean, words are not enough. Just listen and enjoy.